Thank you, Sipatanam, to provide your information. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and good afternoon, sir. On our previous class, we have been discussing about some topics related to CSC 103. The discussion topic was power cord, keyboard, mouse, force of case, expression slot, and other topics. Very details in a very detail. Regarding that topics, if anyone had any kind of question or if anyone have any kind of confusion, you can ask our honorable course instructor. So I would like to request our convener to provide his statement regarding this.
Sifat, ask them, do they have any question or not?
Sir, do you guys have any question about previous class?
No question.
Oh, thank you, sir. You can start, sir.
Sir, I'm requesting our honorable
requesting
teacher.
To honorable teacher to start the class.
Okay, all right. Okay, thank you.
Thank you, sir.
But guys, you guys' performance is not up to the mark, okay?
Yes, sir.
I told you that every day you have to take preparation as convener and as reputier. Please maintain the standard.
Sorry about that. I'm so sorry about that.
Okay, but next time, please maintain the standard. Okay.
Obviously.
In another day, I can call you again. Okay, Sifat. Another day, I can call you again. Okay. So please be serious about it. All right. Thank you. So now let's start our today's session. So let me share my slide with you.
Sir, I want to be clear about the leader's duty, actually.
Sorry.
What is the duty of the leader, sir?
I will talk about the responsibility of course leader with you separately. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Alright. Okay. So maybe in our previous class, let me show you. In our previous class, we already discussed about computer case, computer monitor, computer keyboard, computer mouse, and power cord, isn't it? Five basic hardwares we already done, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
Okay. And I also show you the real one, okay, real hardwares, okay, in your previous classes. So in today's class, I'm going to start with different peripherals. Where is the peripherals? Okay, so here is different types of peripherals. Can you guys see the peripherals here?
Yes, sir.
All right. So the first one is what?
It's a printer, sir.
First one is printer, isn't it? Okay. Yes, first one is printer. And here you can see the explanation. Okay, here. So can anyone read it? What is written here?
Yes, sir.
Anyone?
Peripherals can use with computer. Printer. Mm-hmm. A printer is used to print documents, photos, and anything else that appears on your screen. There are many types of printers available, including inkjet, laser, and laptop photo printers. You can also buy an all-in-one printer, scanner, and copier.
All right. So now tell me what type of device this printer is. Is it input device or is it output device?
Output device.
Very good. Output. So this one is output device. Okay, don't be confused. This one is nothing but output device.
But so, sir, if there is a scanner in it, so it is both, I think, sir.
No, if it is, I mean, all in one, then the scenario might be different. Okay, but if you consider only the printer, okay, then this one is output device.
Okay.
And what it can do, it can convert any soft copy document to hard copy document. Okay. Now you might ask me one question, sir. What is soft copy document and what is hard copy document? Okay. So soft copy document means modifiable. Okay, changeable. We can modify that document. We can update that document. Okay. Like in this slide, if I want, I can do some change, isn't it? Okay. But if I print this document, if I print this slide, okay, then I will get the hard copy. And hard copy, we cannot change. Okay, we cannot modify. Okay, so by using this printer, we can convert soft copy document to hard copy document. Is that clear to you? By using this printer, we can print any document or any photo or anything else that appear on your computer screen. Suppose if I want, I can print this slide as well. Okay, that is the thing. And here you can see the picture. Okay, the printer picture here. So through this, okay, part, we can insert page. Okay, there are different types of page, A4 page, letter size page, okay, different types of page we have. We can insert the page through this point, and then under this cover, we have cartridge, that is called cartridge. Okay, inside the cartridge, we have ink. Okay, through this ink, this printer can print any character or any picture over this page. On at last, through this point, we can get the printed document, the hard copy document. All right, okay, this is the working way how basically the printer works. And there are different types of printer you might find out in the market, like inkjet printer, you might find out laser printer, you might find out photo printers even. So basically in the the place where we take the photo, okay, studio, okay, in the studio they basically use very high resolution printer, those printers basically photo printers. Okay, then we have inkjet printer, we have laser printer. Like there are some ink drum with that printer. Sometimes they are also using laser light to print the character over a page. Okay, so on the basis of those working principle, okay, there are different types of printer you can find out in the market. Then they are basically mentioning about all-in-one printer. All-in-one, what does it mean? That means inside the same device you are going to get the facility printer, you're going to get scanner, and you're going to get copier means the photocopy. Okay, that is basically what all-in-one. Okay, that is the thing. So this is printer, this is your output device. Okay, I think now you have some idea about the printer. If I move to the next slide, then you can see the device called scanner. Okay, the device called scanner. Okay, so Ritu, can you hear me? Ritu?
Yes, sir.
Ritu, can you read the slide?
Scanners. A scanner allows you to copy an image or and save it to your computer as a digital computer readable image.
Very good. Okay, thank you. So now you can understand what it can do. First of all, tell me, is it input device or is it output device?
Input device, sir.
Sure, not output.
Yes, sir. Input, sir.
Is there anyone think that this is output device?
Output device.
Output device. Okay, but you are wrong. This is
input device.
It's an input device.
This is input device.
Input device.
Right. Why this is input device? Now we have to understand. Okay. The working principle of printer, okay, is the opposite of scanner, or vice versa.
Yes, sir.
We can say that the working principle of this scanner is the opposite of printer. Okay. Why I'm saying so? Through printer, what we can do? We can convert soft copy to hard copy. But through scanner, what we can do? We can convert hard copy to soft copy. Okay. You can see the space here. Okay. Space here. We have to insert a document, a picture, okay, through this space. Then we have to close the cover. Okay, then you have to press on the switch. Okay, then what it is going to do, it is going to scan that hard copy document, and it is basically making a soft copy picture. that soft copy picture will be viewable on your screen, on your monitor. That means we are scanning something and we are giving input to our computer through this scanner. That's why this is called basically what? Input device. Ritu, are you okay with that now?
Yes, sir.
You understand why this is input device?
Yes, sir.
We are basically scanning something. Okay. Through scanning process, we are basically getting digital image. And we are providing that digital image to our computer. That means we are converting hard copy to soft copy, the opposite one of printer. Through printer, we can convert soft copy to hard copy, but through scanner, we can convert hard copy to soft copy. Okay, that's why this is called input device. Okay, don't think this is output device. This is nothing but your input device. All right. Now the next one. Speaker and headphone.
Output device.
Nurul Afsar, can you read the slide?
Yes, sir. Output Please. Device.
No, read the slide first.
Speaker and headphones are output device, which mean they are device that communicate information from the computer to the user. They allow you to hear sound and music. Depending on the model, they may connect to the audio port or USB port. Some monitor also have built-in speakers.
Okay, very good. Okay, so now tell me, this is input device or this is output device?
Output device.
This is output device. Why this is output device? Basically,
output device.
And why this is output device? Basically, through this device, we can hear any audio, isn't it?
Yes,
we can hear any music or hear any kind of audio file. Suppose in your device, now you have built-in or separate speaker. Through that speaker, you are getting my voice, isn't it?
Yes,
you can
sir.
Hear me. So you are getting output. Okay, that's why this one is nothing but your output device. Am I clear to you?
Yes, sir.
All right. Okay, so again, let me show you the real one. Okay. I'm sharing my video with you. Let me know whether you can see the video or not.
Yes, sir,
can you see the video from my another
yes,
account?
Yes, sir.
For everyone, is it visible? My video?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Is there anyone facing problem? Let me know. I think all of you can see the video, isn't it? My laptop you can see, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
All right. So now I'm going to show you the speaker of mine. Okay. This is a speaker. Okay, this is one speaker. You can get different model. Okay, speaker always not necessary to look like this one. Okay, you might get, different models. Okay, so this is basically one Bluetooth speaker. Okay, and manufactured by Y. Okay, you can see here. Okay, and as well as I have some wire with it. Okay, if I want, I can also connect this one to my.
Much speaker. Price.
Sorry.
How much price?
Basically, I basically got it with my mobile phone. Okay, so I don't know what is the actual price of it. Okay, I have no idea actually. Huh? So right. So this is basically what one output device. Okay, through this device we can hear music or we can hear some other audio files. Okay, that's really. And this is the headphone you can see. Okay, this is the headphone I have. You can see what type of device this one is. Headphone, input or output?
Output.
Output device. Why?
Output. If there is a microphone, then it is the input device also, sir.
Okay, I'm not talking about the microphone now. Just think about the headphone. Okay. So now tell me, what is what type of device this one is? Input or output?
Output.
Actually, what? Output device. Again, this one is another Bluetooth. Device you can see here. Okay, this is another device I have, and through this device I can also hear music or I can get any audio file. So this is nothing but your output device. Okay, that is the thing. Okay, so I can also show you another speaker. I'm going to show you another speaker now.
Sir, I can't hear you.
Can you hear me now? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Okay, all right.
Let me sir, hello, sir.
Can you hear me?
I can't hear you also, sir. Your audio is stucking, sir.
Okay. But what about rest of you? Can you guys hear me?
Yes, sir.
Then maybe you guys have some internet issues. Okay. Alamin Akash, my voice is clear to you now?
Yes, sir. That is right.
All right. All right. Thank you. So now I'm going to start my video again. Can you guys see the video?
Yes, sir.
Can you guys see my speaker?
Yes, sir. Over my laptop. Yes, sir.
So this is another speaker I have. Okay. Basically, I basically have this speaker with my desktop. Okay. My desktop do not have any built-in speaker. That's why I basically purchased this one for my desktop. Okay. And here you can see we have, can you see the port here?
Yes, sir.
Sir.
This is basically what?
3.5
this is audio port. Okay. That is the thing. Okay. Audio port I have. Okay. This is not USB. Okay. This is not USB. And here I have basically two wires. Another is basically what? This power supply cord. Okay, I have to give separately power to this speaker. Okay, that is the thing. But this one, the previous one I basically mentioned, this one, if you see the speaker, I need not to provide power separately. It has its own battery. Okay, it has its own battery. I just need to recharge the battery. Okay, that is the thing. And this one is USB. You can see one USB port with it. Isn't it?
Yes, sir.
All right. So let me show you the audio port on my computer casing. Can you see the audio port here?
Yes, sir.
The audio port. Okay, yes. Audio in and audio out. All right. Okay.
Yes, sir.
So I can, this one is color coded. If you can see it, this is color coded. One is green, another one is basically red or pink, look like. Okay, that is the thing. All right. So I have to insert this one here. Okay. Then my microphone will work properly. Okay. Is it clear to you?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So now I guess you have some idea about this speaker. All right? Speaker.
Yes, sir.
All right. So let me share my slide again. Okay. Now this one is visible to you, isn't it? My slide.
Yes, sir.
All right. So now the next one is microphone. Microphone. All right. Microphone, yes, is, sir, the next one. And just a minute. Who is going to read it? Alamin Akash, can you read the slide? Akash.
Yes, sir.
I read the slide. Microphone.
Microphone is a type of input device or a device that receives information from user. You can connect the microphone to the computer and use the computer to record sound or to communicate with another computer user over the internet. Many computers come with built-in microphones. Thank you.
Okay, very good. So now you understand what type of device this one is. So microphone is input or output?
Input device.
Right, microphone is input device. Very good. So why I'm saying so, this one is input device. Microphone basically taking my voice, okay, and giving it to my computer, isn't it? Okay, suppose now we are basically discussing, okay, with each other, okay? So my laptop has a built-in speaker, okay, or microphone, okay. Through that microphone, it can catch my voice, okay. Then through my computer, it is basically delivering to you, and then by using your speaker, you can hear my voice, isn't it?
Voice.
So that's why voice. Yes, it's basically nothing but your input device. All right, speaker. So I'm showing my speaker to you, okay, so that you have some idea. Okay. Can you guys see the video now?
Yes, sir.
Yes, yes sir. Sir.
All right. So make it large. Okay. So this one is visible to you, isn't it? The video from another account. Okay. And you can see my headphone again. This headphone, I have two facility. I can use this one as a speaker or the headphone. Okay, that is the thing. It has two facility. Okay, simultaneously I have two facility over there. Okay, and you guys are very familiar with the mic or the microphone, isn't it? Okay, in many function, you basically saw the mic and the microphone, isn't it? Okay,
yes,
so
sir.
Microphone is nothing but your input device. Okay. Again, move to my slide. So here you can see the next one is web camera. Can anyone tell input me device. What type of device web camera is, input or output?
Input device.
Input.
How many of you think that this is input device? How many of you think that this is output device?
I think.
Sir, I think this is the input device.
Okay. Input device, sir.
Is there anyone think this output device? Any different opinion do you have?
I don't think so.
Okay, right. So webcam is not output device. Many of you make mistake here. This is actually what? Input device. This is nothing but your input device. This is not output device. Be careful. Okay, this is not output device. This is,
yes sir,
nothing but your input device. Am I clear to you?
Yes sir.
Okay. Okay, so Deepanita, yes, can you read it?
Web cameras. A web camera or webcam is a type of input device that can record videos and take pictures. It can also transmit video over the internet in real time, allowing you to do video chat or video conferencing with someone in a different part of the world. Webcams are used often in business, and they also help many friends and families stay connected. Thank you, okay, sir.
Very good. Thank you. So now you have some idea about the web camera. So like with your computer or laptop computer, with your smartphone, you have built-in web camera, isn't it? You have built-in web camera. Or with your desktop, you can connect a web camera separately. Okay, that is the thing. So this web camera, what it can do, it can capture still image or it can capture moving image means actually what? The video is nothing but moving image. Okay, so it can capture those images and it can deliver it to you, to your computer. That's why this is nothing but your input device. Am I clear to you?
Yes sir.
All right, then the next one, what is the next one? Okay, joystick. Those who are computer game freak, okay, they have very good idea about the joystick, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
Does anyone have this joystick?
Yes, sir. I have.
You
yes,
have?
Sir. I yes, have sir. Got I one. Have.
Okay.
I have one.
Any of
I
you have
I had one, but not recently.
Okay. So you guys have. Now we have number of computer gamer. Okay, in our class. Okay, right. So joystick, yes, is input or output device?
Input device.
Input device. That means through this joystick, we can give instruction to our computer. To different character what we have inside the game, we can control them, isn't it? Through this joystick. So that's why joystick is nothing but your input device. All right?
Yes, sir.
Then digital cameras. Digital camera, nowadays, it has screen as well, isn't it? A screen as well with it. So in this case, we can say that this is actually both input and output. Through input camera, we can capture, and through that display device, we can see.
See.
Isn't it?
Yes.
So that is,
yes,
nothing but your input output both. Okay, right. And most of the cases nowadays we have digital camera with USB port. Okay, previously we had SATA port, PATA port, or serial port, or parallel port, but nowadays we have digital camera with USB. I mean, whatever the devices we have now, now we are basically developing, or the manufacturer are developing, they are basically developing those devices with USB port. Okay, USB giving us number of advantages. Okay, that's why they're using basically what? USB port. Data transfer rate is very high in USB. Okay. So that's why all the components basically come with USB port nowadays. Okay. Then the last one, mobile phone, MP3 player, tablet, computer, and other devices. They are basically what? Different types of peripherals. So what they're mentioning here, when you buy an electronic device such as a mobile phone or MP3 player, check to see if it comes with a USB cable. If it does, this means you can connect it to your computer. Okay, that means not only your mobile phone or MP3 player, some other devices we have, basically if they come with your USB port, okay, come with a USB port, then you can call that. That is basically what? That we can connect with our computer. Am I clear to you? I would like to show you an example, okay, an interesting one. Give me a moment. So I'm going to open my video again in front of you. I'm stop my sharing and I'm going to open my video. Let me know whether you can see the video or not. Can you see the video now?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Can you visualize something on my laptop?
Yes, sir.
What is this?
Wallet. Money bag.
Wallet, sir.
Wallet, sir. Wallet.
Okay, my wallet. Okay, right. Okay, so my wallet, or you can say my what is this money
bag. Output device, right. Sir.
Money bag.
Yes, sir. Right. Yeah, money bag.
So now my main point is not to familiar with you this wallet, okay, or not to show you how much money I have inside the wallet. Okay, the main factor is that few moments back we learned that which device basically come with USB port, we can connect those devices with our computer. I'd like to give you an example. Okay, this is not actually general or normal wallet.
It's a smart wallet.
Can you guys see the tag written
smart
here?
Yes, sir. Smart. Yes, sir. I can see smart. The tag is smart.
Smart wallet. Okay, that is the thing. And here I have a power button. Okay, here I have a power button. Though is it hazy, I think you can understand it or you can guess it. There is a power button I have here. Okay, that's
it. Thanks, sir.
Under this Rexin, not Rexin. This is actually leather. Under this leather. Okay, right. So let me show you the port I have here. Can you see the port here? A small port I have here.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. We can see.
Okay. I think you can see. And here I have my cable, my USB cable. Okay. Through this small USB cable, I can connect this
with computer.
This wallet with my computer. Okay. So let me connect it. Okay. Then I can show it to you. Give me a moment.
Sir, what the advantages of?
Okay, so now you can see this USB port connected with my wallet, isn't it? Okay,
yes,
this is the USB port you can see. This is the USB port you can see. So if I connect this through my laptop, okay, this is the USB port. Okay, I can connect it through my laptop. Okay, that's it. Now, can you see the power here? Okay.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Giving a light. Okay. That means now it is charging basically.
Charging.
Okay. And yes, through this power button, here I have the power button under the leather. Okay. Through this one, I can make it open. Okay. I can make the sensor activate. Here is a sensor I have. So I can connect this one with my mobile phone, and I can track it down. Where is my wallet?
Okay. Wallet is.
So many things I can do. I have a I have to download a software that is basically Android software I can download. Okay, that is the thing. So you understand? I mean, we have whatever the devices we have with this USB cable, the USB port, we can connect those devices with our computers.
Is it clear? What is the specialties of this wallet?
Suppose you forget to take your wallet, okay, when you're going outside, okay, then you will get warning from your mobile phone. You have your mobile phone with you, okay, then your mobile phone will give you warning. Or you forget to take your mobile phone, okay, then you have your wallet with you, your wallet also give you signal, okay.
Or lost your wallet, then you can track down.
If I lost my wallet, I can track down what was the last location of my wallet, okay, or where it is moving. That is the thing, okay. So this type of facility it is going to give us. So that's all about different types of peripherals. I think now you guys have idea about those peripherals. Okay. So now I would like to discuss what type of question you might get from this part. All right. What type of question you might get from this part. Okay, I might give you a list of peripherals name, and you have to find out what type of device they are. What type of device they are. Like if I mention in the list that projector is input or output?
Output and input, both, sir.
No, projector is output
device. Output, sir.
Through projector, we can, visualize something. Okay, that is the thing. Projector is output device. Then think about scanner. Scanner is input or output?
So input, sir.
Input, sir.
Okay, all right. Then touch screen monitor.
Input, sir.
Input, sir.
Input, sir.
Input,
sir.
Input,
also, input.
Output. Visual things also, sir.
It's output.
Sir, output device.
Both. Touch screen monitor is both. Okay.
Both.
Touch screen monitor is both. Input and output, both. Okay, right. So think about your think about your RAM. RAM is what? What type of device this one is? RAM?
It does the both, sir, I think.
RAM or hard disk or your pen drive, which is storage device we have, they can play role as input, output, both. Mm-hmm. Because we can store something and we can retrieve something from them, isn't it?
Yes,
so
sir.
In this case, they are basically playing role as input and output both. But mainly we have three types of device: input, output, and storage. Input, output, and storage. So in the list, if you find out hard disk, what you are going to say, that is storage.
Storage.
If you find out in your list pen drive, what you are going to say, that is storage device.
Storage.
So we have input device, we have output device, and we have
storage
device. Is it clear to you?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
All right. Thank you. So now, what else? Okay. I'm going to share my slide again with you. Okay, so now I would like to discuss about what we have in the front side of the computer casing, what we have in the back side of the computer casing, and what we have inside in your computer casing. Okay, inside your computer casing. Okay, these things we are going to discuss. Let me open my slide. Okay, so let's start with the front side. What we have in the front side of our computer case. Can you guys see the slide on your screen?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. All right. Yes, sir. We can see.
All right. So you can visualize the picture here, isn't it?
Yes,
you can
sir.
Visualize the picture here. Okay, all right. So this is the front side of the computer casing. So let's see what we have in the front side of the computer casing. First of all, which component they're mentioning here? Optical disk drive. Right. So by using this optical disk drive, what we can do? This is the portion. Okay, this is the optical disk drive. And here we can insert our CD or DVD disk. Okay, here we have a button. Okay, if I press this button, then it will open this tray. This is the tray we have here. Can you see the tray? I'm marking it. Okay, so they're going to open this tray. Okay, and then we can place one disk over it. Okay, and there is a optical reader. That optical reader can read the disk. Okay, small optical reader we have. That optical reader can read the disk. All right. So this is basically nothing but your CD or DVD ROM. This is the device we have in the front side of the computer case. So let me show you a real one. I'm basically showing my video again with you, sharing my video again with you. Okay. Can you guys see the video now?
Yes, sir.
Okay. This is the front side of the computer casing. You can see here. All right. And if I put my computer more, more closer, then you can see here one DVD ROM. Okay, this is manufactured by Samsung. You can see here, and this is the button. Okay, if I press it, then there will be a tray coming out from here. You can see the tray. This is the tray. As I do not have any power now with my desktop. It is not going out, but here I have a button. If I press that button, then this tray will come out. Okay, that is the thing. Am I clear to you? Okay?
Yes, sir.
Right. And we can place the disk, place my disk on this tray. All right. The next thing I have, that is, again, follow my slide. Next component I have, that is USB port. We have number of USB ports. Okay, so again I am starting my video. Can you guys see the again front side of the computer case?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so here I am basically showing the USB port. So in the front side we have two USB ports. Can you see the USB port here?
Yes, sir.
And we can connect our USB cable. Okay, through this port. Okay, here I have a USB cable, and if I want, I can insert it here. Okay, like this. Okay, or I can insert the USB cable here as well. Is that okay? Two USB port we have. Okay, universal serial bus, USB in short, USB. Okay, then what we have according to our slide, we have power button. Okay. Let me show you the power button. Okay, so here you can see the power button. Can you see the power button here?
Yes, sir.
Okay,
yes,
sir. This is the power button to start our computer. We need this power button. You have to press this power button like this. Okay, and here we have one LED light. If it is power, if it gets power, then automatically that light will be open, and it will indicate that I have power in my computer. Okay, right. All right. We have a power button. Then what we have? We have audio in and audio out port. Audio in and audio out port. Okay. So let me show you again in the front of the computer casing. Follow my video. So here you can see. Here you can see audio in and audio out port. So we can plug like this. We can insert the audio port like this. This is the audio port you can see here. Okay. We can insert it here. Okay. All right. Okay. So this is the audio in, audio out. Okay. Audio in and audio out. These two ports are color coded. Okay. All right. Then let's see what we have. Okay. Okay. Then also some other options also available here. Those are not they mentioned in the slide, but I would like to show you. Like here you will get one restart button. Can you see this button?
Yes, sir.
This is basically my computer's restart button. Through this one, I can restart my computer. Okay, reboot my computer. Then here I have one LED bulb, LED light. It basically indicate my computer ports are working properly or not. Okay, that is the thing. Then here we have some false cap. Okay, false plastic we have here. Suppose if I want to add some other things, okay, here I can break it down. Okay, like this. Can you see that? Okay, I can open it. Okay, like this. Okay, and I can place any other device here. Okay, like another CD-ROM, another DVD-ROM. Okay, I can place here floppy disk. I can place here. Okay. Okay. So also here we have another false part. You can see. Okay, here we can place the floppy disk or this type of thing. If I want, I can place here. Okay, that is it. If I press it harder, then automatically it will break down. Okay, on that time I can place another device here. Okay, and you can see that this casing basically manufactured by Gigabyte. Okay, Gigabyte, they are the manufacturer of this casing. So am I clear to you what we have in the front cell of the computer casing?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
All right, so remember we have again I'm repeating. Please focus on my slide. We have optical disk drive, then we have USB port, number of USB port we have, then power button, okay, audio in, audio out port, we have restart button, we have number of LED lights, and we have some false place where we can insert our CD-ROM, DVD-ROM or floppy disk and other things. Am I clear to you the font side of the computer casing? All right, so now I would like to show you the back side of the computer casing. Okay, the back side of my computer case. Okay, on the computer casing. So give me a moment. Okay, give me a moment, please. Now okay, in the slide you can see the backside view of the computer casing. So can you guys see the backside view?
Yes, sir.
Right. So here you will get the backside view of my computer casing. So here number of ports basically available we have. Okay, so can anyone read this text? Anyone? Please read the text. Any of you?
Sir, may I?
Please, carry on.
Backup computer case. On the back of the computer case are connection ports that are made to fit specific devices. The arrangement of these varies from computer to computer. And many companies have their own special connectors for specific devices. Some of the ports may be color-coded to match a color on the device, which will help you determine which port is a particular device.
All right. So first of all, they mention here, inside the backside of the computer casing, you will get number of ports. You will get what? Number of ports. Okay. Let me draw it. Okay. Here we have. Just a minute. Here we have number of ports, you can see. Okay. Okay. Audio port, audio in, audio out, then USB port, then monitor port. Okay. Then we have SATA port, PATA port. Then we have internet connection cable port, Ethernet port, you can say. Then we have this power cord port. Okay. Number of ports we have. Okay. And some of them are color coded. Okay, especially these two. though the picture is very small, okay, they are color coded. Okay, I saw you, I showed you this one earlier, isn't it? One is a purple color, another one is green color. It basically indicate which basically we use for keyboard and which we use for computer mouse. That is the thing. Can anyone tell me what is the name of this port? In your previous class, I mentioned.
Sir,
PS2 port,
sir.
Right, PS2 port, okay. PS2 port, okay, right. PS/2, okay. That means personal system version 2, okay. In your previous class, you asked me this question. Exactly what? Personal system version 2 or series 2. Okay, that is the thing. All right. So now I would like to show you the real one. I'm sharing my video with you again. Let me know whether you can see the video or not. I'm going to show you the backside of the computer case. Just a minute. Okay, so before showing the video, I would like to show you the port names given here. Can you see the slide now?
Yes, sir.
Power socket.
Yes, sir.
First one. In our previous class, we basically saw this power socket. Then audio in and audio out. We have two audio in and audio out in front of the computer case, as well as we have these two in the backside as well. Then Ethernet port, we have, this is called Ethernet port, and here we can connect our broadband connection cable here. Then USB port, we have number of USB port we have. So at first I'm going to show you these four ports. Okay, let me start my video. Can you guys see the video?
Yes, sir.
The back side of my computer casing, all of you. Can you see this one?
Okay, all right. Yes, so, sir.
First of all, let's put my light over there and you can get it. Okay. All right. So here you can see now, number of ports are available. First of all, they mention about the, what is this port?
Power cord, sir.
Power cord port, isn't it? Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So yes, here I can show you again the power cord. This is my power cord, and I have to place this power cord in this port. Okay, is it clear to you? And I have to connect this plug, okay, in another socket, one socket or multiplier. Then through this power socket, okay, my computer going to get electricity supply. All right, 3-pin power port we have. Then what is the next one they mention about? Maybe the audio in and audio out. So can you see again? Audio in and audio out. So here we have number of ports for audio in and audio out. Okay, that is the thing. Okay, this is the port again we have. You can connect your like this type of audio, okay, port, okay.
Sir, what is the blue code?
Here we have two options. You can connect the output one, the speaker one, either this one or either this one. You have two options, okay, available. Okay, this is for your microphone, and they are basically color coded. And actually, if I put it very closer, then I think you can guess, you can see some, I mean, mark over there.
Okay. Yes, sir.
Okay, I think it is not that much clear, but you can imagine. Okay, this one is basically what? This one basically printed over there, a microphone symbol. Okay, there is the speaker symbol given. Okay, over there. So these two basically for speaker you can use, and this one is for microphone. Okay, all right. Audio in, and these two are audio out. All right. So then they mention about, what? This is basically what? Ethernet port
connection.
So what your Ethernet port. So if you want to connect your computer with broadband connection, okay, that means if you want to access internet, on that time you have to connect your broadband line through this, okay, port. This is called Ethernet port. Okay. Can you guys see one, cable on my hand, in my hand?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
This is your, this is the example of your Ethernet cable. Okay. That is the thing. Okay.
Excuse me, sir. We have only 5 minutes remaining.
5 minutes remaining. All right. Thank you for your reminder. So we have two side of it. One side we have to connect with this port, and the side we have to connect with the router. Okay, if you have router, then you have to connect with that router. So let me show it how we can inject this one. We have to hold this cable like this, then we can inject it. Okay, like this. Now, okay, if I connect this one, if I connect this cable with my router, I have a router. In another day, I am going to show you that router. But through this cable, if I connect this cable with my router, then I will be able to access internet through my desktop computer. Is that okay? Okay, you understand? The Ethernet port.
Yes, sir.
It's called Ethernet port.
Yes, sir.
And this is actually nothing but an Ethernet cable. And here we have one connector. This is called RJ45 connector. RJ45 connector. It's look like basically your telephone connector, isn't it? Okay, in telephone connector. Okay, but this one is nothing but your actually what? RJ45 connector. This is called RJ45 jack. Okay, that is the thing. All right. All right. Then what else we have inside the slide? Okay. Okay. So we have number of USB port. You can see here. Can you see USB port? Number of USB port we have.
Yes, here. Sir.
Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. USB port. Okay. Right. You can connect your keyboard. You can connect your mouse or other device. Okay. Which device basically support USB port? Okay. Then again, if I go back to my slide, then in the next slide I have monitor port. This is the monitor port I have here. Okay. Can you see the monitor port here? The blue one.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
The monitor port. So I have a cable. Okay, through this cable I can connect my monitor with my, what is this? This is the casing. Okay, with my computer casing. Okay, this is the monitor port I have. Okay, all right. Okay, let me show you that cable, monitor cable. Okay, give me a moment again. Okay, I'm going to show you that cable. Give me a moment. So, can you guys see cable here?
Yes, sir.
Okay, this is the cable. You can see. Okay, let me show it here. You can get the full view. Okay, this is the monitor cable. Now you can see, isn't it? And here we have two parts, two side again. This is one side. You can see here number of pins inside it. Okay, and this is another one. Okay, I have here. So, and what I can do, here we have the monitor port, and we can connect like this. Okay, we can connect this port like this. Okay, and here we have two screw. You can see here. Okay, we can give tight. Okay, by using this two screw, we can give tight. Okay, now it is totally attached with this computer casing. Okay, and another side, that means this side, we have to connect with our computer monitor. All right. Okay, so now I think you have some idea about this port. Okay, then which port we have, they mentioned there in the slide. We have serial port. Can you see the serial port? Okay, this is the picture of serial port.
Yes, sir.
This is the serial port. Okay, my finger, follow my finger. This is the serial port, and this is the parallel port. We can see serial port. Inside the serial port, we have number of pin. Inside the serial port, we have number of pin. Inside the parallel port, we have number of hole. Okay, number of holes we have. Okay, so think about the old version.
Sir,
video cameras. Okay, we have to connect those old version video camera with this serial port or parallel port. I'm clear to you.
Hello, sir. My regard is connecting with. He is connected with the serial port.
Sorry. Can you repeat the
question? My TV card. Sir, my TV card is connected with the serial code, sir.
Okay, huh? There are a number of devices. Okay, we can connect with the serial code. Okay, that is the thing. Okay, so video camera is one of them. Your card is one of them. Okay, so different types of peripheral we can connect with this one. Okay, right. Then we have PS2 port. You already have idea. These two things are nothing but your PS2 port. Can you guys see the PS2 port here? Color coded. Okay. These two PS2 ports are color coded. Can you guys see these two PS2 port? Okay.
Yes, sir.
Nothing but your PS2 port. Personal system version 2 port we have here. Okay. Then we have, I already mentioned, this is nothing but your parallel port. Okay. You can see the picture again in the slide. Okay. This is the parallel port. Okay. But nowadays we are not using these two port. Okay. We have very limited use of these two port because whatever the devices we have, all of them are coming with the USB port. Okay, right. Then we have number of expansion slot. Can you see the expansion slot?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Slot we have. Okay. So here we have some false protection given. If I press it harder, then it will break. And I can insert different types of card. Okay. My sound card, my audio card, my graphics card. Okay, I can insert here. Okay, this is the expansion slot. Okay, this is very, vulnerable. If I give a press, okay, if I give some energy and press, then automatically it will break down. Okay, that is it. And in different slot, I can insert different cards. Okay, or other different device I can attach with my motherboard. All right. You understand the point?
Yes, sir.
Okay, yes, sir. So that's yes, all sir. About what we have inside the out. The backside of the computer casing. So I would like to show some other things. Like we have switch here. Okay, switch here. You can see. Okay, I can make it on. I can make it off.
Sir,
okay.
I have a question.
Please.
Sir, how many things we have? Can we have at in expansion slot?
Many things. It basically depends on your motherboard capability. Okay, if motherboard has number of capability, then it can connect different types of device. Okay, number of device. Okay, there is no limitation. It basically depends on model by model. Okay, it depends on your motherboard model as well as the casing model. Okay, that is it.
Okay, sir.
All right, and this is actually what? One switch. Through this switch we can on and off. Okay. So basically we can on or we can off our power supply unit. Okay, if I provide electricity, but if this switch is off, then computer will be off because I'm basically switch off my power supply unit. Okay, so I can control my power supply unit through this switch. Okay, and here you can see one, what is this? Cooling fan. Here I have a cooling fan here. Okay. Here I have another slot for the cooling fan. Okay, that is the thing. So that my internal device, what we have inside the computer casing, they get proper airflow. Okay, so that I can maintain proper ventilation. Is that okay? Okay, so I guess now you have idea about what we have what we have front side and what we have in the back side of the computer case, isn't it? What we have in the front side and what we have in the back side of the computer case. Do you have any questions so far? Okay, as you do not have any question and as we are running out of time, so I'm going to terminate the class soon, but I would like to give you one reminder about the examination. Okay, Saturday we have a quiz test, okay, on chapter number 1. So take a very good preparation. All right?
Yes, sir.
Sir, when will you take the quiz actually?
And now I would like to take your attendance. Deepa, Nita, are you present?
Yes.
Okay. Then Nurul Absar. Nurul Absar is present.
Yes, sir.
Rajul Islam Saqib. Saqib is also absent. Then Shaun. Shaun, are you present? Okay, I cannot see you, Shaun. Then Shifa, Tasnia Shifa.
Present, sir.
All right, Shaju. Shaju, are you present? Okay, Shaju. Then Arif Mahmood. Arif. Okay, then Ritu. Then Mashfi. I saw Mashfi. Okay, I can see Mashfi. 3032. Then Samin.
Electricity problem, sir.
Sorry?
Sorry, electricity problem.
Electricity problem, all right. Then Sabir.
Yes, sir.
Anunna.
Yes, sir.
Then Tanvir.
Yes, sir.
Rimu.
Yes, sir.
Dihan.
Yes, sir.
Shubho.
Yes, sir.
Al Amin Akash.
Present, sir.
All right. Then Dhrubo.
Yes, sir.
Sifat. Sifat Anuris. Then Raihan. Raihan Mahmood. Raihan, are you present? Okay. Then Dolon.
Present, sir.
Then Najmus Saqib.
Yes, sir.
All right. So in today's class, Raihan Mahmood. Okay. Then who else? Then Shaju. Then Shaun. Then Saqib. 1, 2, 3, 4. These four students are absent. Okay. All right. So that's all about today's class. Okay. So go through all the things from your book. And if you have any problem, then let me know if you have any problem. All right. So that's all about today's class. Have a nice weekend. Okay. So see you in the next week. Till then, be safe. And Allah Hafiz everyone. Goodbye.
Sir.
Any question, Tanvir?
Sir, when will I contact with you? When you are free, actually.
I'm going to contact with you. I have your phone number. Okay.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
All right. Okay. Thank you. That's all about today's class. Okay. Have a nice weekend. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you, sir. Assalamu alaikum, sir.
Assalamu alaikum, sir.